welcome and welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be all about what it's like to be a medium, what it's like to communicate with spirit. I figured that now would be a really good time to jump into this, considering that my last video was all about channeling. I received a lot of questions about what I receive from spirit and how I receive from spirit. I'm just gonna talk a little bit about what that's like and kind of like my day-to-day life. Now before I jump into that, I really just want to mention again how I'm in the category of people who discovered my mediumship abilities at a very specific point in my life. I did not live my whole life knowing that I could do this or even being aware of the spiritual realm. So this all, you know, came out just a few years ago for me. And so my life has actually changed pretty dramatically since I really kind of embraced this ability and this part of who I am now. First of all, I want to talk about what my first impressions of mediums were, and it was the kind that I'd watch on like after school TV shows, not the ones who go into a crowd and say like, okay, your grandma's coming through. Never watched those. I still haven't watched those actually. Mine were more of the kind where it would be like the haunted house series. It'd be like a newlywed couple. They find a house like on the East Coast in Pennsylvania somewhere. It's been on the market for 10 years, super cheap. Nobody knows what's wrong with it. Turns out, boom, it's haunted. So they'd call in the paranormal investigator team. Paranormal investigator team would call in a medium. And then that person would come into the house and they would always do the same thing. They would always walk in and be like, looking up at the ceiling, I sense a presence. To my surprise, it is actually, it's exactly like that. I actually find myself doing that a lot, especially when I travel. I'll walk into a new place and be like, ooh, there's energy here. On that note, traveling has completely changed for me. Can't just go wherever I want anymore and not think about, you know, what's gonna be there, because I now pick up on energies that I otherwise would have never noticed there before. I have to take that into account when I travel now. I actually now bring this little kit that I made everywhere with me. It's like a little travel kit, like just my little spiritual box. So this is my little travel kit. I have a lighter in here. I have some salt and some eggshell powder. You never know when you don't want to be bothered. Another lighter, just in case. I've got a couple of candles in here. White sage from my backyard. I grew it myself. Then I have a piece of smoky quartz, some clear quartz chips. In case I want a crystal grid, I have my pendulum in here. Yeah, it's just all the essentials, just in case.
So it's just stuff to kind of like cleanse the place if I need to, or, you know, keep spirits and energies out if I don't want them in my space. It's not all necessary to have these things, but they make me comfortable. And if it makes me comfortable, it's necessary. You know, it's kind of like a lifestyle change. Like if you were to, you know, get a dog or a cat for the first time and travel with them, you kind of now have to take into account like, okay, like I have to look into pet friendly places to stay. I have to bring their food. I have to bring their water bowl. So, you know, that's what it's been like for me. It's been a lifestyle change. And so, you know, just like any lifestyle change, you have to adjust to the newness. The biggest question that I used to look up back when I was first realizing that I was developing these abilities was, what does connecting to spirit feel like? The answer is different for everybody because it's different for everybody. The biggest indicator for me that there was like spiritual energy around, that there was a spirit around, was I would feel a really random sensation of nausea. Yeah, either random nausea or like random bouts of anxiety. Even though it wasn't really anxiety, it was more like a rapid heart rate. Ooh. That was my signal that there was spirit trying to connect with me. Whereas I could be lying in my bed, totally relaxed, completely comfortable, and then my heart rate would just spike out of nowhere for absolutely no reason that I knew at the time. Like the level at which I'm at now, I receive spirit in a multitude of different ways. You know, I'll get images the way that you see in your mind's eye, which is very much like your imagination. Like if you were to be reading a book and then, you know, you're picturing the characters in your mind's eye, that's exactly how I receive the images. Sometimes, this has only happened on like a couple of occasions, I'll have like an overlay happen, which is where, say I'm like looking at my hand and then suddenly a hologram will begin playing like in front of it. And obviously it's not there. It's like a very much a projection.
And sometimes that'll happen where I'll just see like a movie playing in front of whatever I'm watching. I have not yet seen a full-on apparition. Yeah, I'm not ready to be walking around seeing spirit as if they were solid people right in front of me. I think I would be very confused and probably very freaked out, at least at this level. It hasn't happened yet. I feel like it probably will at some point in the future, hopefully when I'm more ready and not in a situation where I will scream. I'll hear phrases or words in my mind as if it's like a thought. Sometimes I'll hear it as if they said it in a physical voice right by my ear. Different tones, different volumes, different voices, different languages too, and accents, which is probably the coolest one for me. Like, I've had a few people come through with like Brazilian accents and like Latin American, and I'll pick up on emotions, on memories, on sensations. Especially in my dreams too. Like, I'll get a lot happening in my dreams, very clear messages. It's probably the easiest way and probably my favorite way, because I am A, sleeping, and B, it's just so much easier because you already receive so much in your dreams. I love dream messages. Dream work is my favorite. So I actually haven't done much trance yet, which is where you kind of like let your consciousness step out and let spirit step into your body. I haven't really done much of that yet. I really prefer to stay like present and aware and stay in my body so that I can better support. You know, if I'm in a reading, that's like, I want to stay present for whoever I'm reading for, and I want to stay present in my body so that I know what I'm feeling and I'm able to better pass the message along that way. Now, about working with spirit, oh my gosh, I absolutely love it. It's absolutely magical. Like, you know, I'll get all sorts. I'll get past family members, angels, ancestors, I'll get dragons, mythical creatures. You would be surprised to know like how many beings you have around you at all times. Now, do I have spirit coming at me 24/7? Actually, no. When I was first like developing and had absolutely no sense of boundaries, yes. They would be coming at me all the time. I would be like out grocery shopping and then feel like something coming at me, and I'd be like, no. Not the time and not the place. Boundaries actually definitely come in handy, especially during the winter seasons. This is gonna sound so silly and kind of really sad, but I actually, Halloween used to be my favorite holiday. I do not look forward to that time of year any longer. You know how they always tell you, like in folklore, like, oh, that's when the veil becomes thin, is on All Hallows Eve or Day of the Dead, and you know, all the holidays around that time of year where the days are shorter and the nights are longer. Well, it's true. It is absolutely true. The veil is so much thinner, and there is so much activity again, like between like October to early January-ish, that's when the veil is super thin. And so I start to pick up so much more energy around that time. It's as if you had the radio on and you were listening to your favorite station for, you know, the entire year. Suddenly there's like five other channels trying to get in on your radio station, and there's just static and frequency everywhere, and it's like cutting in and out. There's just too much going on. There's just too much traffic. You know, I'm feeling like more stuff wandering around that time. There's definitely more like random encounters that I have about, you know, spirit just like wandering the earth. So yeah, boundaries, very important. But aside from that, you know, I love working with spirit. Like, it is such a part of who I am. You know, it's really helped me through a lot of like light and dark moments. It's really carried me through a lot of those moments throughout the past few years. But it's also important for me to, you know, stay balanced and to stay centered. Like, I honestly do not know of any medium who is on 24/7. Like, it is something that you can actively control and be more open or be more closed, and being open all the time is just very, very draining in a spiritual sense. Like, it takes a lot of energy. Another funny story is, actually, it's such a part of who I am that I will more often now get like all these occurrences happening where I'll just attract people who need some kind of spiritual help. Like, I was working at my job the other day, and this guy comes in and all frazzled, and he's just like, oh my god, okay, I don't know if you can help me, I don't know who can help me, but you're gonna look at me all crazy, but I think I have a ghost in my house. And I just looked at him like, oh, okay, well, what do you need for that? And he's like, oh my god, I don't know, do you have any like sage? We didn't, but I was like, oh, you know what, we actually have this oil, like we carry this oil that you can use. He didn't know anything about this stuff, clearly. He just had no idea what to do about a situation. So I lead him over and I tell him how to use it, and he's like, oh my god, like, you know so much. And I was like, yeah, you know, I do this all the time. And he's like, oh, what, you do this all the time? Like, what do you do? Ooh. I almost gave myself away. Like, I still have a day job. Honestly, there is so much that I can cover about this topic. There's so much that I want to talk about. And I think that my next, my spiritual awakening story, part three, not six, is going to be more about how I got, like, all the details of the nitty gritty, like how I learned to receive, what the work that it took, the way that it healed me. And that was just such a huge part, is that it was such a healing journey in my life to be able to learn how to do this. It really solidified, you know, my faith in myself and my belief in spirit and the universe. All right, so we'll end it there. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. Drop a comment down below if you have your own stories or resonate with this in any way. And I will see you in the next one. Bye.